Hello and welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on analog multiplexers. This video will provide an introduction to failsafe logic found in analog switches and multiplexers. The goal of this video is to learn the features of failsafe logic and its advantage to your end equipment. Before we jump into failsafe logic, I will explain how an ESD diode in a traditional switch works. In the setup shown here, both the subsystems and the switch are powered with 5 volts. The ESD diode prohibits any current flow from VDD into select. The signal on the select pin will only flow into VDD if it surpasses the maximum ratings mentioned in the datasheet. This is usually 0.5 volts above VDD. Due to this, the device is protected from ESD events up to the datasheet specification. If the second power rail is unpowered, as indicated in this picture, the diode is not operating as intended due to the lack of a potential on VDD. A current can flow from select into the VDD rail. There it can back power subsystem B. This unwanted voltage can damage the switch and subsystem B if their max ratings are violated. This is especially worrisome as the current might not be limited by the design. Even if the max ratings are not exceeded, if subsystem B is a microcontroller, this may cause issues on boot up as register settings are not set correctly. This is often the case when the switch and subsystem B is unpowered while the subsystem A is already operating. The digital logic is backpowered as well and may turn on the switch. Unwanted currents can flow through the open switch and might damage the signal ports on subsystem B. A TI switch with failsafe logic will maintain a high impedance state on the signal path and digital logic pins when the switch supply is unpowered. The internal protection will prevent current to flow into VDD. Thus, the switch in subsystem B remains protected. This feature can be found in all TMUX devices. The failsafe logic feature also eliminates the need for a voltage translator if different voltages are used within the design. For example, subsystem A, powered with 5 volts, can control a multiplexer powered with 3.3 volts. The signal levels still need to comply with the switch ratings. Thank you for watching the TI Precision Labs video, Failsafe Logic. To find more switches and multiplexers, technical resources, and search products, visit ti.com/switches.